Dr. Jaleel Parker, senior pulmonary consultant at the Leelavati Hospital, joins us live from Mumbai at the moment. Thanks so much, Dr. Parker, for being with us this morning. I want to begin by asking you, are you worried at all about the COVID surge as far as Maharashtra is concerned? The central team seems to suggest that this is the onset of a second wave.
Yes, of course, I think this is the onset of the second wave. I think to a very large extent, the people are to be blamed because they are not wearing masks, they are not keeping some social distancing as has been recommended. This surge was expected, so was it in other countries, and it has come here. And unfortunately, even though the government is trying its best to vaccine the population at large in the city of Mumbai, in the state of Maharashtra, it is the people who are not cooperating with the government. And I think they should. If you ask me, is lockdown the answer to this? I don't think so. Well, they might bring certain restrictions and that would be good. Otherwise, as it is, our economy is not doing well. People are frustrated. They're not having jobs. There's no source of earning. So I think we'll have to take the government will have to take a calculated decision in this regards. But social distancing, wearing of masks, sanitization, and even vaccination, I think, would be the answer to this surge. And that's the only way out. Another thing that I have observed is that the criticality of the COVID-19 patients has reduced dramatically. Though the surge is there, though the admissions are there, but they are not that critical as we had seen around 5 months back, 8 months back, etc. So I think even we have experienced as to how to treat the patient in a better way. Our ignorance is no more there. So I think we are doing a wonderful job, and I think the government is doing a wonderful job too. One more thing I would like to add is that, you know, all those in the upper middle class, the rich, etc., I think we should pay for the vaccine, including us frontline warriors, etc., because we can afford. And the same could be used by the government to vaccinate the poor who cannot afford.
Well, you know, that's an interesting point you make as far as the larger vaccination strategy is concerned. Dr. Yatin Mehta, the chairman of the Medanta Institute of Critical Care, also joins us from the Delhi NCR region. Thanks so much, Dr. Mehta, for being with us. You know, while, of course, there is a disproportionate rise in cases if you look at Delhi and Mumbai, for instance. And we're talking specifically about these two cities because the surge in cases primarily is being seen in urban areas and in cities at the moment. What would you attribute? I know COVID-appropriate behavior not being followed, large crowds, no social distancing, no masks is something that we've talked about. But what explains the fact that, you know, there's a disproportionate rise in cases as far as Maharashtra is concerned? And thankfully, one isn't seeing that big a rise elsewhere in the country at the moment.
No, Rishika, I think you just need to go to the shopping areas in Delhi and see what is happening. I mean, it is as if life is normal and COVID is out of the window. I mean, people have completely thrown out all the precautions. You go anywhere. When you go to a restaurant, you only see the waiters in a mask. The customers are not wearing anything. They're not maintaining any distances. Life is back to normal. This is what is happening. I think there is no rocket science in this. Bombay, we know, is overcrowded and slums are there. But that problem is not there in Delhi. It is just mismanagement. I mean, they should not open up religious activities. They should not open more than 50 guests for marriages. There is no need to do all that. I think we are not over the hump as yet. And we should be very, very careful. And vaccination also does not guarantee foolproof protection.
Yes.
I mean, it takes 2 weeks after, at least 2 weeks after the second shot. And at the moment, only 3 crore Indians have been vaccinated. So
yes.
I think vaccination at the moment is not the main thing which is going to protect you till it becomes effective and you are able to give it to a larger number of people. But all these precautions must be strictly implemented. I mean, we cannot ignore these things.
I think, Dr. Mehta, you make a very important point, and I think this is important to underline and highlight for the benefit of our viewers as well, that even if you receive the COVID-19 vaccine, immunity doesn't really kick in 2 weeks after your second dose. So just because you've received the vaccine doesn't mean that you don't follow COVID-appropriate behavior. Dr. Parker, you raised a very important point earlier about the fact that while, of course, cases are surging and Maharashtra continues to remain the worst hit, the severity of cases thankfully seems to be lesser than what we saw, say, in the first wave. Why do you think this is so? And can we then say that the second wave perhaps will be milder?
Well, there are a couple of answers to that. Number one is that I think we have got into the what is called as herd immunity. And that is why the severity is not so much. Number two, the ignorance of the medical fraternity, which was there initially, has changed over a period of time as COVID-19 has evolved. And now we are in a better position to treat the patient in the nick of time. We nip the severity at the right juncture. And that is why the patients do not go on the ventilator. Number, as I said earlier, that herd immunity is already in there. Number three, vaccination, yes, of course. That is why the severity that you intend to see is not being seen.
Yes.
Doctors are more practical now. They start the treatment well in time. Even the patients are aware that they should seek medical assistance. And that is why the severity has come down, of course.
Right. Okay. So heightened awareness among patients and, of course, the medical fraternity per se is more equipped now to deal with COVID-19 infections. That's an interesting assessment. But Dr. Mehta, coming to the other point of, the pace of vaccination, do you believe that it is important to liberalize, the vaccine dissemination criteria? At the moment, Dr. Parker made a point about how it should be opened up. In the free market, people who can afford it should be able to pay and get the jab.
See, I think the government is hastening the pace of vaccination. There is no doubt. See, it started with a limited number of private hospitals. Now, even some clinics are, many clinics are giving it. And initially, the restriction was only to COVID app. Now, it is you can have a walk-in registration with the senior citizens. Many of them find it easier to do that. So it is happening, and the private hospitals now allowed 24/7. So many of them are functioning 24/7 jabs. So it is almost for the higher risk category, it is almost freely available.
Right.
Yes, it is not available to young people, yes, who are low risk category. Ideally, it should be open to everybody, agreed. But when there is a limited manufacturing facility, I think we will have to do this way. High risk first, elderly first, then comorbidities, then younger patients. So this will come like this. I think I would expect in a couple of months' time, other vaccines also will come into the market. And I think we'll be quite all right after 2 months or so, I would expect it.
All right. Well, it is a worrying development in terms of the uptick in the number of cases. Maharashtra particularly worrying there. Dr. Jaleel Parker and Dr. Yatin Mehta, thanks so much for sparing your time and joining us on NDTV this morning. Remember, the Prime Minister is chairing an all-important meeting with the chief ministers of different states to take stock of the COVID-19 situation in India. We'll keep a close watch on all those developments.